Sunk costs can give an incumbent firm an advantage over potential entrants. Recall that sunk cost refers to cost that has already been incurred and cannot be recovered. We will see that the firm that has already incurred unrecoverable cost will compete differently than firms for which the cost is still prospective. To see this, consider how two hypothetical companies compete, Sam's Shipping and Rhonda's Railroad. Sam ships by boat up and down the coast of Greenland. His costs include the 100 ships that he could rent out to a shipping company in Iceland. This is his best alternative use for the ships. He also incurs fuel and labor cost. The cost of the ships is a fixed cost, as it does not vary with output. The fuel and labor costs, however, do vary with output and are therefore variable. If he ships 5 million tons of cargo per month, his average fixed cost is $100 per ton. Average variable cost is $10 per ton. This puts average cost at $110. To be profitable, Sam must charge at least $110 per ton. Rhonda's Railroad is in direct competition with Sam, as she also ships along the coast of Greenland. She has incurred costs from the installation of tracks and railroad cars. These costs cannot be recovered and are therefore sunk. She also has fuel and labor costs that vary with output, so they are variable. If she ships 5 million tons per month, her average amortized sunk cost is $100 per ton. The average variable cost is $10 per ton. She would like to cover all of these costs and charge a price per ton of $110. Suppose that demand in Greenland is such that there is room for only one company. However, due to some accidental oversight, both companies open at once. Which of the two companies will survive? As they compete with each other, a price of $30 per ton is established. What will Sam's Shipping Company do in the long run? To answer this question, let's look at Sam's opportunity cost and compare it to his revenue. His per unit opportunity cost is $110. His per unit revenue or price is less than his average cost. Since price is less than average cost, Sam's Shipping Company is not covering its opportunity cost and is earning a negative economic profit. This implies he is not doing as well as his next best alternative, which is renting the ships out to the shipping company in Iceland. So in the long run, that is what Sam's Shipping will do. He will exit the market and rent the ships out to the company in Iceland. What will Rhonda's Railroad do in the long run? When going into business, Rhonda had planned on shipping at a price that would cover both the variable and average amortized sunk cost. However, currently, the price is only $30, so this is not possible. Should she exit the market? To answer this question, let's proceed as we did when analyzing Sam's situation and explore her opportunity cost. For Rhonda, her opportunity cost is the direct expenses she incurs for the fuel and labor, or $10 per ton. This is because there is no opportunity cost to using the railroad track and cars in her business. There is no alternative use for them. She cannot rent them out or sell them. The cost of the railroad track and cars is sunk and cannot be recovered. As long as the price is above the average cost of $10 per ton, Rhonda is covering her opportunity cost and is operating an economic profit. Another way to look at this is Rhonda's options are much less. Once she has laid the railroad track and purchased the cars, she has to be committed. There are no other uses for these assets. She has burned her bridges in every other direction, so to speak. A company with sunk costs becomes a fierce competitor. When making pricing decisions, the company can profitably drop the price much lower than a company for which the sunk cost is still prospective. This implies that sunk costs can give a company a competitive advantage over potential entrants.